The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 21, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 10th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation. Such a man of understanding acts with mind and intelligence perfectly controlled, gives up all sense of proprietorship over his possessions, and acts only for the bare necessities of life. Thus working, he is not affected by sinful reaction.
Nirasi jatachityatma tapta sarva parigraha sariram kevalam karma kurban natnoti kilmisham. This is required in human life. It is not forbidden that you starve. No. That is not stated in the Shastra. Javadattha vininnayam. To keep your health and the body and the soul together, you must live very nicely so that you may not be diseased. Because this human form of life is meant for making a progress so that all the problems of life may be solved. it is required. Juktahara viharascha in another place. Juktahara viharascha yoga bhavati siddhi. When one becomes yogi, our real purpose of life is to become yogi. Yogi means to re-establish our connection, our lost connection with God. At the present moment, in our material condition, we have forgotten our relationship, our eternal relationship with Krishna, our God. Nitya siddha Krishna bhakti saddha kabhunat sabanadi suddha chitte karay udar. The Krishna bhakti, our love for Krishna, is there eternally. But on account of our contamination with this material world, we have forgotten our relationship. Just like a mad man, he forgets his relationship with the family. He loiters in the street. He eats anywhere and everywhere, and all rubbish things. Although he may have very rich father, well-to-do family, but forgetting, madness means forgetfulness of his real life. So, we are now forgetful of our real life. This has been also exemplified by a Vaishnava poet. Pishachi paile jana moti channa hoy, mayagrasta jiver sei dasa upojoy. Pishachi, when a man is haunted by ghost, as he speaks all nonsense, he cannot recognize his father and mother and relative. Sometimes he calls them by ill names on account of being ghostly haunted. Pishachi paile. Similarly, in a conditioned state under the influence of Maya, we are also talking so many nonsense things. I belong to this family, I belong to this nation, I belong to this community. My business is this, simply forgetting Krishna consciousness. All other business, he'll remember. But when he's requested to become Krishna conscious, to understand Krishna, he doesn't like. Except Krishna consciousness, he'll take all responsibility and work hard for that purpose. This is called Maya Krishnaji. Nirashi, now to go to our original position, that is called tapasya. Tapasya means to revive our original normal life of Krishna consciousness. That is called tapasya. This tapasya is not possible by the cats and dogs or animals. Tapasya is meant for the human being. Therefore, the human life is called durlabhajan. Durlabha manuso janma. Tadapi arthadam adhurvam. Prahlad Maharaj said, Kaumaro acharit pragya dharman bhagavataniha. Durlabham manusam janma. Tadapi arthadam adhurvam. He advised his class friends, my dear friends, from childhood we shall learn the science of Bhagavad Dharma. Bhagavad Dharma means to re-establish our lost relationship with Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of God. And this can be solved in this human form. Therefore, education of Krishna consciousness should be given from the very childhood, Kumara. Kumara means from the age of 5th year up to the 10th year. This is called Kumara. So we have opened our school in Texas. We are training very nicely all these children. And they are very learning. Children, as you teach them, they learn. They are innocent. Unfortunately, we do not give them training about Krishna consciousness. We give them education for sense gratification. How you can earn money, economic development. Economic development means to get more money and to satisfy senses more and more. This is the modern theory. Krishna says that to achieve the perfection of life, one should be nirashi. Nirashi means unnecessarily desiring for sense gratification. Unnecessary. Everyone has got right to live and live nicely. For that purpose, there is sufficient arrangement by the Lord. Eko je bhunam vidudhati kama. There is sufficient arrangement. No living being will starve. There is such arrangement. But when we forget more and more Krishna and God, nature will punish. There will be restriction of supply of foodstuff. That is nature's law. Devi jisa gunavai mama maya durastaya. Mami muja prabaddante maya mitam. So present crisis, food crisis, everything is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita does not say that you live by breathing air. No. Bhagavad Gita says, anna bhavanti bhutani. Anna means food grains. There is necessity of food grains. Annas bhavanti bhutani. Bhagavad Gita never says that you don't require to eat. You simply breathe air and practice yoga. No. But we must eat neither more nor less. That is the command. Yuktaharu viharus. We should not eat more, not less. And nirashi, nirashi means desire less of extravagance. Now we are desiring for sense gratification more and more. That is not wanted. If you want perfection of life, this is called tapasya. One has got the desire, but he should not desire unnecessarily. Everyone has got the right to eat, even the animals, everyone has got the right. But because we are desiring to enjoy more, therefore we do not give the chance to the animals to live properly, rather we are trying to eat the animals. This is not required. This is called nirasa. Why you should eat animals? That is uncivilized life. When there is no food, when there are aborigines, they eat animals because they do not know how to grow food. But when the human society becomes civilized, he can grow so many nice food. He can keep the cows instead of eating the cows. He can get milk, sufficient milk. We can make so many preparations from milk and grains. So we should not desire unnecessarily to enjoy more. Then it is said here, kurban na apnati kilmisham. Kilmisham means resultant action of sinful life. Kilmisham. So, if you don't desire more than our necessary, then we are not implicated, involved in sinful activities. Kurban napi. Even though he is engaged in working, while you are working, knowingly or unknowingly, you have to commit something which is not pious, even sinful. But if you simply desire for living properly, then kurbannapi na apnati, na kilmisham. Kurbannapi na apnati kilmisham. Our life should be without any sinful reaction. Otherwise we'll have to suffer. But they do not believe, although they are seeing so many abominable lives, where from they are coming. 8,400,000 species of life. There are so many lives living very abominable condition. Of course, the animal or the living creature does not know. But we human beings, we should know why this is this abominable life. It is Maya's illusion. Even one is just like a pig is living in a very filthy condition, eating stool, and still he's thinking very happy, and therefore he's getting fat. When one feels happy, I am very happy, he becomes fatty. So you'll find these pigs, they're very much fatty, but what they eat? They eat a stool and live in a filthy place. But they think that we are very happy. So that is Maya's illusion. Anyone who is living in a very abominable condition of life, Maya, by illusion, he's thinking that he's all right. He's living very perfectly. But a person who is on the higher stage, he sees that he is living in a very abominable condition. So, this illusion is there, but by knowledge, by good association, by taking instruction from the Shastra, from Guru, from saintly person, one should understand what is the value of life and lead like that. So this is instructed by Krishna, that nirasi, one should not be unnecessarily desireful more than his necessities of life. This is called nirasi. Nirasi, another meaning is that not very much fond of material enjoyment. And that is possible when he is in full knowledge that I am not this body, I am spirit soul. My necessity is how to advance in spiritual knowledge. Then he can become nirasi. These are the items for tapasya, austerity, penance. People have forgotten now. They do not know what is austerity. But the human life is meant for that purpose. Tapo dibbam putrakajina suddhe satya jina brahma saukham anantam. These are the instructions of the shastra. The human life is meant for tapasya. And as tapasya, therefore, in the Vedic way of life, the beginning of life is tapasya, brahmachari. Brahmachari. A student is sent to Gurukul for practicing brahmacharya. This is tapasya. Not comfortable life. Lying down on the floor, going door to door for begging alms for Guru. But they are not tired, because they are children, if they are trained. These austerities, they become to practice. They call all women, women, mother, mother, give me some alms. And they come back to Guru's place. Everything belongs to Guru. This brahmachari life, this is tapasya, tapo dibbam. That is Vedic civilization. That children should be, from the very beginning of life, trained up in tapasya, brahmacharya, celibacy. Brahmachari cannot see any young woman. Even the guru's wife is young. He cannot go to the guru's wife. These are the restrictions. Now, where is that brahmacharya? No brahmachari. This is Kali Yuga. No tapasya. But according to Vedic civilization, varnasram dharma. Vedic civilization means four varnas and four ashramas. Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra. We have begun our lecture on the basis. Chatur varnam maya sishtam gunakarma vibhaga. So this is civilization. Unless one comes to this standard of civilization, varnasram dharma, that is animal civilization. So we prefer animal civilization. Therefore we are living like animal also, fighting like cats and dogs, and suffering like cats and dogs also. This is the position. Nirasi jata chitta atma. Control. I shall accept as much as I require. Not more than that. Not less than that. Controlling the chitta, intelligence, an atma, mind, or self-control. Nirasi jata chitta atma. Tatta sarva parigraha. Parigraha means unnecessarily collecting something. Atyahara. Atyahara prayasas. Sri Rupa Goswami has given definition how bhakti is killed. Atyahara prayasas ta prajalpa nyamagraha lulam janasangascha sarabhi bhakti pranasat. If you want to advance in spiritual life, bhakti yoga, then you should avoid all these things. Six kinds of. Sarabhi, six kinds. Bhakti pranasati. What is that? Atyahara. Eating more than you require. Actually, we should not eat unless we are very hungry. That is good eating. When you are hungry, you can eat any ordinary things, still you feel very satisfied. Not routine eating. Routine eating must be there. We shall not eat more than that. But the best principle is that if we do not feel hungry, we should not eat. There is no hunger and at the same time no appetite, and we eat, that brings indigestion. Dysentery, indigestion. So why should we accept? Therefore it is forbidden, utyahara. Ahar means eating. Eating more than required. And ahara means collecting also. Collecting more than necessary. Utyahara prayasas. Prayas means things which are done with great endeavor. No. We shall accept things which is very easily done. Not to waste our energy unnecessarily. Atyaro priyasa. Prajalpa. Talking on nonsense. Sitting together and on the newspaper, such politicians said like this, such social workers, all nonsense. Practically try to avoid all these newspaper reading. Or talking on nonsense subject matter. That is called prajalpa. Atyaro priyasasta prajalpa niyamagraha. Niyamagraha means schedule work, rules and regulation, not to accept. Niyam agraha and niyam agraha. Agraha means unnecessarily agraha, but without any result. That is called niyama agraha. You must follow the rules, regulation, so that you are benefited. But if you are not benefited simply by following the rules and regulation, that is agraha, only for the rules and regulation, not for the result. We must see that there is result. Niyama agraha. Janasangasta. To associate with unwanted people. You must associate with devotees, not others. They are called janasangas, a low long, greediness. Sarabhi bhakti, pranasat. If you are a student of devotional service, you must avoid all these things. And just the opposite number, Usaha, dhajya, nishchaya, tattat karma pravartana, sato vitte, sadhu sanghe, sarabhi bhakti, prasiddhati. Prasiddhati means you increase. What is that? Utsaha, ennaba. In this life I must fulfill my mission of Krishna consciousness. That is called utsaha. Dhajya. Don't be agitated because it is not giving result immediately. Just patiently, born, working. Usaha, dhajya, nishchaya. Nishchaya means to have full faith in the words of Krishna. Krishna says, kaunteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranasati. This is called full faith. The Krishna has said, that if I am in devotional service, I will never be lost. Krishna will give me protection. Krishna says, ahamtva sarvapapi bhamakhasyami. So have faith. This is called surrender. Not that all Krishna says, but may not be able to protect me. No. Krishna is able. He is all-powerful, omnipotent. He can give you protection. When he says, that ahantva sarvapapi pamakhasyami, that is a fact. This is called nishchaya. Certainly Krishna will give me protection. Not that because I do not see Krishna, I do not know whether Krishna will give me protection. No, that word is sufficient. This is called Nishchaya. Usadhajya Nishchaya. Tattat karma pravartanat. But you must follow the rules and regulations as it is enjoined in the Shastra. Not that Krishna will give me protection and I may do whatever I like. I can eat anything I like, I can do anything I like. Just some rascal advises that there is no such thing, restriction, in the self-generalization. You can eat anything, you can do anything. People like that program. And as soon as there is restriction, they do not like. Because we put so many restrictions, I am called in the Western world, Ramiji, you are very conservative. So, we have to become conservative. Follow the rule. Not that we give liberty, that whatever you like, you do, and at the same time, you make progress, spiritual life. That is not possible. Because spiritual life means tapasya. Formerly, great saintly persons, they underwent very, very severe tapasya. For thousands of years, hundreds of years, then they attained success. In the Kali Yuga, it is not possible to undergo such severe tapasya. There is concession. The concession is that you live a pure life and chant Hare Krishna mantra. This will make sufficient. A pure life, no illicit sex, no intoxication, no meat eating, no gambling. This is pure life. These boys and girls who have joined this movement, they have given up. They are not dying. Nobody will die if he lives a pure life. Anyone will make progress. Tapasa, brahmacharya. These are the injunctions of the Shastra. If you want to be happy, this is the tapo dibbam putraka jina shuddhi to satta. Satta means my existence. At the present moment, my existence is not shuddha, purified. Just like if your health is contaminated, then you get some disease. So, for the soul, the living entity, this disease, janma mitra jara vyadhi dukkha dosha anadarsana, this is a kind of disease. Not, it is a fact, because the soul is eternal, nitya shashvata na hanyate hanyamane sarire. The soul is eternal. It does not die. It does not annihilate after destruction of the body. But there is change of body. Mrityu, janma mrityu means change of body. Tatha dehantara prapti. So people should be intelligent to know why I shall undergo this tribulation of repetition of birth and death. But they do not know it. There is life without birth and death. Tatta deham punarjanma naiti. After giving up this body, never taking birth again with this material birth. There is a life like that. We get this information. Why should we not fulfill this mission of life in this human form of life? Why unnecessarily desire so many sense gratification? This is called tapasya. If all life we have enjoyed the sense gratification, ahara, nidra, vaya, maintenance, eating, sleeping, sex life, and protection from fearfulness. Now this has been done in so many lives. Why not in this life make a perfect process so that no more death, no more birth, no more disease, no more old age. They think it is all utopian, but we don't think. We believe in the words of Krishna, words of the Shastra, and we are trying to accept it, practice it, and preach it. And this is Krishna consciousness movement. Thank you very much.